I'm so happy that we could connect, Yash, with Sherwood. I'm just filled with a lot of gratitude whenever we talk of our old school. And I know it's a little off the track, but first of all, let me thank all the students for the wishes that they sent me on my birthday, and thank all of them for the wonderful video that they made for me. Coming down to the school, I know that Sherwood has always been a great pride for me, and a lot of it has come from the fact that in our school, during the time when we were in boarding school, there was an atmosphere of cleanliness from the very first day. There used to be inspections, there used to be dormitory inspections where you had to keep your dorm clean, your bed properly made, and when we went on parade, it was like a parade that you formed in front of the dining hall before actually marching in into the dining hall to eat your foods. That was like an inspection time where the teachers used to inspect whether your tie was properly worn, whether your shoes were polished. So I think these were the habits that were inculcated in us from a very early age. And that, I feel, is the beginning of what this entire campaign is all about.
Mr. Bachchan, exactly the same words told to me by students here, and you know, talking about dorm cleanliness, surprise inspections and checks, exactly the same words. So let's just go across to, you know, the school captain, and he has a question for you.
Good afternoon, sir. So we believe that what we learn at an early age remains with us throughout our life. So here at Sherwood, we clean our campus every day as part of its daily curriculum. Shouldn't other schools to take up this initiative, you know, so to imbibe in us the values of cleanliness?
Yes, thank you so much. It's wonderful to hear the school captain talk like this. When I was in boarding, I mean, I know that we were always put to all these regimens of cleanliness, but the school captain never spoke to us in this manner, that, you know, we are all interested in cleanliness. It was something that came and had to be, you know, almost like a routine put onto us. But I'm very happy to see the school captain talk like this. He is the bearer of all the good and bad news of the school. And if he's saying like this, I'm sure that the students must be following it through.
Absolutely, Mr. Bachchan. There are a lot of kids here. You would remember this iconic, you know, this auditorium. I'll ask another question. She's the head girl of the school. You have this beautiful Nenni Jheel, the Nenni Lake here. You know, how much does pollution, and that too in hills, affect a beautiful lake like the Nenni Jheel?
Now, I am very attached with Nainital and this town. It really shrinks my heart when I see this lake being polluted. Now, environmentally, our school water supplies are also blocked, and it affects the locals plus every school child. So it really affects us, and we really want to make Nainital plus the country better for the next generation.
So that is what, you know, the sentiment is, because in the hills, when during rains, the silting happens, the plastic and everything goes down, and it blocks the daily water supply of many things, because, you know, this school is higher up above than the Nenni Lake. So it takes a lot of time for the water to come back up, and it has to be pumped up, and that plastic blocks the water channel for the school. A lot many students are here. Let's just talk to some of them as well. This cleanliness drive that you did today, I'm sure this is not the only day that you do this. You do this all year round.
The cleanliness drive is a usual routine. We make sure that we do it on a daily basis. So Sherwoodians are like, they want a clean campus, and they like to keep the campus clean.
All right. Mr. Bachchan, there's one question for you from this boy here. Can you introduce yourself?
Sir, this is Manik Arora from Sherwood College, Robin Hood House. And sir, today in India, with so much of illiteracy and lack of civic sense, how do we get more awareness among these people to let Swachhata be a part of our daily routine?
Yeah. Well, first of all, because you've mentioned about it, I'll say everybody should go and join Sherwood College, because you people are very educated and talking about it at least. But that is really what we need to do. We need to start talking about it. And all you students of the day in Sherwood are aware. A lot of the things that you say and do as a daily routine is being seen and watched, you know, all over the country. through the medium of NDTV and this wonderful program. And I hope that they follow something. We've been to several other schools, we've been to several other locations, and everybody is just talking about it. And we see a lot of participation. And participation is something that is very impressive. Because when you participate at this young age, you will continue to do that as you go along. So keep doing the good work. And may every good person that works for cleanliness deserve a prize, because you know what the motto of Sherwood College is: Meriat Quisque Palmam. Let everyone deserve a prize. And if you keep this cleanliness drive going, I'm sure that all of you will deserve a prize.
Right, Mr. Bachchan, I think on that note, we're probably going to have to leave it there for the moment. Thank you all so much for joining us from Sherwood College. Just thank all the people who are there, all the kids who are there with us.
I also just want to add here that, yeah. You know, during my time and before the school became a co-educational, we were just boys. And the only time that that our sister school came up to the to Sherwood was either during a play or during the annual week. And that is the time that Sherwood used to look the cleanest, because the girls used to come there. So I want to tell them, now that you have the girls as a co-ed, make sure that every day is as clean as possible. And another thing, a lot of the students don't know that the swimming pools that you have there were actually dug by my class in the year 1957-58. That entire two big swimming pools were dug by us personally. And every piece of rock that was removed to make space for that swimming pool was very properly put on the cut side and not just disposed off. It was put there to make and strengthen the mountain that was there.
Right. You know, I can't resist. Now that Amitji has given us both those anecdotes, I have to get you to get somebody to respond to that. Is the school cleaner now through the year because it is co-education? Or is it has that novelty factor gone, so therefore they're not bothering about it?
Well, Vikram, you know, I'll just toss this question to another girl here. So the question that Mr. Bachchan asked, is the school clean after being going co-ed?
Yes, sir, it is clean. We have labor quotas for this purpose. We ask the students to clean it every Sunday and every time possible. Like sir told us, we have inspection every Tuesday and Friday to maintain our own personal hygiene. So I think the school is clean now.
Great, thank you.
So school is clean, the school is hygienic, and to end with, there's this very special poem that a student has written, and this is about cleanliness. So I'll just hand over the microphone to him. Can you introduce yourself as well?
I'm Apoor Bikram Shah, sir, and good afternoon, sir. Once again, greetings from the home base. Last year, I had the honored privilege of being applauded by you. But sir, what I feel now is that my aspirations, your aspirations, are yet not achieved. We have a lot more to conquer, miles to cover. Aur yahi khayalat jab mere zehen mein aaya to main apni kalam ko rok nahi paya. Aur is saal Pune 2 October ke is avsar par aapko ek kavita nivedit kar raha hoon. Aur agar is kavita ke madhyam se jo miles hame aur cover karni hai, unme se do char kadam bhi ye desh badh lega to mera kavya paath safal rahega aur aapka sunna bhi sarthak hoga. जो सरहद पर तो जा न सके पर अपना फर्ज निभाते हैं, अस्वच्छता नामक शत्रु से भारत देश बचाते हैं, अस्वच्छता नामक शत्रु से भारत देश बचाते हैं, दो पल वतन के आज उनके नाम करता हूं, जो सड़क नाले साफ करते उन्हें सलाम करता हूं। जनाब पर विडंबना देखिएगा इस देश की, घिन आती है लोगों को जिनसे, जमाना जिन्हें धिक्कारता है, वो ही सच्चा सैनिक है जो गंदगी को मारता है, तो दुनिया की नजरों में जो कूड़े कबाड़ी वाला है, सही मायने में वही हिंदुस्तान का रखवाला है। एंड व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट नेशनलिज्म, एक अलग ही ज्वार हमारे रगों में उठने लगता है सर। हम इस हद तक भी बोल देते हैं कि हाँ वक्त पड़ेगा तो हम इस देश के लिए सरहद पर जान दे भी सकते हैं और ले भी सकते हैं, बेशक हम ऐसा कर सकते हैं, पर जब भी मैं सड़क के किनारे कचरे के किसी भी ढेर को देखता हूं तो सर मुझे लगता है कि हर एक वो ढेर इस दावे के आगे एक प्रश्न चिन्ह बनकर खड़ा हो गया है। यूं तो हम सब सरहद पर पौरुष दिखलाना चाहते हैं, इस्लामाबाद की धरती पर भी ध्वज लहराना चाहते हैं, और ये ख्वाब बेशक पूरा होगा, यौवन में वो ताकत है, शेरों के जो दांत गिने रक्त में वही हिमाकत है पर भरत वंशियों की हालत आज शर्म आती है बताने में। हम नाक सिकुड़ने लगते हैं एक कागज का टुकड़ा उठाने में। तब सोचता हूँ ये दौर ऐसा कर लेगा क्या सचमुच अपने हाथों में वसुंधरा अंबर लेगा। अस्वच्छता से मैत्री है तो रज तिलक क्या लगाएंगे। जो हाथ झाड़ू उठा न पाए संगीन कैसे चलाएंगे। और सर अंत में मैं बस यही कहना चाहता हूं कि सरहद सैनिक बचा लेंगे बैठे वतन की साधना में। हम भी तो कुछ अर्पण कर दें भारत माँ की आराधना में। और हम क्या अर्पण कर सकते हैं सर एक भीष्म प्रतिज्ञा अब हर जन भारत का ले ले। एक भीष्म प्रतिज्ञा अब हर जन भारत का ले ले। अटूट प्रेम स्वच्छता से हर मन भारत का ले ले। अटूट प्रेम स्वच्छता से हर मन भारत का ले ले। तो युद्ध का ऐलान अब गंदगी के खिलाफ हो और मांग शवुड की जनता से है देश का कचरा साफ हो। हुक्मरानों से उम्मीद यही आशा है जवानी से। हुक्मरानों से उम्मीद यही आशा है जवानी से। और हम क्या आशा करते हैं सर बस एक यही आशा मैं जो करने जा रहा हूं जो निवेदन अंतिम इल्तिजा जो आपसे रखता हूं मैं सर बहुत ही I really feel honored that I am speaking in front of you. परम आदरणीय अमर कवि श्री हरिवंश राय बच्चन जी की वंशावली के सबसे चमकदार सितारे के सामने ये इल्तिजा अगर मैं कर रहा हूं और शायद अगर ये आपके अपने विद्यालय के प्रांगण से ये निवेदन उठ रहा है तो हिंदुस्तान इस पर अमल जरूर करेगा इस बात की आशा कर रहा हूं सर। और तब अंतिम पंक्तियां आपको निवेदित करता हूं। हुक्मरानों से उम्मीद यही आशा है जवानी से। इल्तिजा गांधीवाद की हर एक हिंदुस्तानी से। संदेश हमारा जमाने भर में हर पहर जाएगा। जम्बुदीप का जयघोष गगन में बेशक घेर जाएगा। भले खूना बहाएं सरहद पर एक छिलका अदब से उठाइए बिना पवन ही अमर तिरंगा खुद ही लहर जाएगा। जय हिंद।
क्या बात भाई साहब ये कविता हमको जरूर भेजिएगा आप। मैं बहुत प्रभावित हुआ हूँ आपके इससे और एकदम रोंटे खड़े हो गए हम सबके यहाँ पर। ये कविता हमें आप भेजिएगा प्लीज मैं इसको अपने हृदय से लगा के रखूंगा और छापूंगा भी।
वाओ अमित जी क्या आपके स्कूल में सर सब ऐसे ही हैं क्या कि
सर देख रहे हैं आप मैं आपके बगल में ही बैठा हूँ।
एक तो आप यहाँ बैठे हैं दूसरे
भाई मुझे बड़ा गर्व है मुझे बड़ा गर्व है और ख़ास तौर से हर वर्ष ये एक ऐसी कविता पढ़ के सुनाते हैं मुझे तो बड़ा आश्चर्य होता है कि कहाँ से इतना विद्वान यहाँ शरवुड में पैदा हो गया है लेखक है कवि है और क्या क्या बातें इन्होंने लिखी हैं। बहुत बहुत बधाई आपको और शेरवुड को बहुत बहुत बधाई और जितनी भी शिक्षा आप प्राप्त कर रहे हैं ख़ास तौर से स्वच्छता की ओर वो इसी तरह जागृत रहे यही हमारी प्रार्थना है। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।